It's that they put the authors in the middle and in between in their dispute, which is a business dispute between the publisher and the distributor and Amazon. And what's happening with their choices that Amazon made, they began to hurt authors. And what hurts one of us hurts all of us.
So some of the accusations that are made in this letter are that the pre-order button is gone for some of these books, for example, on Amazon, or that it might take up to weeks for them to get delivered. At the same time, you just heard Samuel's report. Amazon is a big company, and a lot of us think, well, this company makes, you know, billions and billions of dollars. At the same time, their profitability has been very strained. It's been under pressure. Shareholders are angry. This is also a business. What do you say to that?
Well, they are a business, and they have a perfect right to use any kind of techniques that they think will earn that profitability, but not on the backs of the authors. Hmm. And that I think that that's the real key, and that's the key to Authors United. And it, the letter does say we don't take a stance on the dispute.
Right.
What we are asking is that Amazon not put the authors in the middle.
You know, what's interesting, and what Samuel and I were just talking about, is this fine line, though, that Amazon is going to need to walk between trying to get the percents, et cetera, that it wants, right? But at the same time, not alienating customers. At the same time, as an author, don't you rely hugely on Amazon? And when you think of other places for people to buy books online, what do you think of even these days?
Well, there are certainly other online distributors. There's Barnes & Noble.
Sure.
There's Google Books. There are other places where people can order books. But I do know that a number of my friends who are readers, who are not authors as well, they go directly to Amazon. If it's not there on Amazon, they just presume that it's not available.
Right.
And I think that that's really the key, that Amazon is so powerful. And yes, authors need Amazon. We need all of the online booksellers, as well as the independent bookstores and the brick and mortar bookstores. But because they have such power, and because there's so many people who go to Amazon first, not only for books, of course, but for all kinds of other products, when you disappear from Amazon, you're disappeared.
Yeah.
And that's really a problem, certainly for the authors affected by this dispute. But in the long run, it's so for all of us.